नहीं आएगी समझ।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैडम।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
Good morning, everybody. Today our topic is laptop maintenance. Yesterday we are discussing difference between desktop and laptop, and laptop what is the difference between desktop and laptop. And in laptop have inbuilt display and audio and keyboard and touchpad. Today we are discussing laptop block diagram. In laptop, this is the processor. This is the graphics memory computing hub. Generally, we are called north bit. And this is the input-output controlling hub. Generally, we are called south bit. This is the BIOS. In this, this graphics memory controlling hub directly connecting to display pins here. And showing here, this north bit directly connecting to display. But from this chip to this display, in between, we have some sections. I am eliminating that one. Okay. First, graphics memory connecting hub. Next, LBDA section after display. Means here, first, we understand this display directly receiving signals from which section. And this RAM slots directly connecting to which section. This graphics chip is supporting to which section. Actually, in our laptop, we are using graphics chip. That M here, it is. Means every GMCH internally have some video RAM. So if you want extra, that time they are added extra graphics chip. And this is the IOCH. Here, this IOCH directly connected to keyboard. Means the keyboard related section also means IC subsection is available. And next touchpad. Next audio. Means from here to this IOCH is sending digital signal. After we are converting digital to audio, digital to analog signal, and the analog signal amplifying. After that, amplified signal is connecting to this speakers. Means in between have sections. Means here I am directly explaining this section is connecting to this section. But in between have some supporting chips. So I am eliminating that one for easily understanding purpose. Here IOCH. Here. This IOCH is connected to keyboard, touchpad, audio means speakers, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth. And here, IO port side, this GMCH is controlling to this VGA port. If you want to connect a projector, that time in older laptops have VGA port, nowadays have HDMI port. New laptops have HDMI port. High definition multimedia interface. It is giving high resolution video output, HDMI, compared to VGA. Next to USB, LAN, audio, these are always under control of IOCs. And here, this is a processor. This processor section also works with some voltage. This GMCH also works with some operating voltage. IOCH also works with some operating voltage. BIOS means this BIOS is works with. If power is available, that means it works with power. If power is not available, it works with CMOS diode. Now, in this laptop, we have two power sources. One is the adapter, means external. Another one is the battery. Here, adapter. Adapter is providing approximately, depending on laptop, 19.5 volts. And your battery. It is providing approximately 11.5 volts. Now here, each section is receiving different voltages. For example, processor. Depending on the processor and generation, this process is works with 0.8 volts to 1.25 or 1.25 volts, depending on the processor generation. And this GMCH also works with 1.5 volts to 2.5 volts, depending on that chipset. 1.5 volts. It is also same. This also works with 1.5 volts to 2.5 volts. Means here, available voltage is either 19.5 volts or 11.5 volts. But here this section is works with 1.2 volts or 1.5 volts, this one, and this is 1.5 or 2.5 volts. This is the operating voltage. So now this section's required voltage is 1.5, 2.5, for example, 2.5. So here available voltage is 19.5 or 11.5. Now here each section is receiving voltage from one DRM, voltage regulating module. That DRM section is receiving either 19.5 volt or 11.5 volt, and it is converting it 19.5 to 0.8 volts or 1.25 volts, and it is sending that voltage to this crossbreaker. And this GMCS also have one DRM section. That DRM section is receiving 19 volts or 11.5 volts, and it is converting to 2.5 volts. And this IOCH also. And RAM section also have one VRM section, VRM, voltage regulating module. So this VRM section is receiving high voltage and it is converted to high current. That is the main feature of VRM. Why we are using VRM? Directly we are connecting 1.5 volts to processor from adapter. And 2.5 volts from adapter. IOCH also 2.5 volts for IOCH from adapter. But why we are designing that laptop adapter 19.5 volts? Why we are reducing that voltage to 1.5? Reason is here. This VRM section is receiving high voltage and it's converted to high current. That purpose here we are using VRM section. Generally we have some doubts. Already we have voltage regulators 7805 and 7802 and 7808 voltage. 7802 means we have voltage regulators. Directly we are connecting this 19.5 volts to that voltage regulating IC, and we are connecting that 2 volts to this crossbreaker or 2.5 volts to this crossbreaker. Otherwise, we are using LM317, means variable voltage regulator. We are using that and we are setting that voltage to this section. But why we are using VRM? Means this VRM is converting voltage to current. That purpose here we are using VRM section. Means in laptop or desktop, each section is receiving power supply from VRM section. VRM section means every section, either north bit or south bit or RAM slots or processor, every section maintaining individual VRM section. That VRM section is converting voltage to current and it is sent that to that required section. Means the processor. Processor section also have here for VRM. Means here I am using this same system. Thanks.
VRM. Nice. There also one VRM. And here also one VRM. Voltage is the regulating module. And this all sections receiving raw supply from adapter. Means here, this raw supply is directly connecting to this VRM section, and this VRM section is converting that voltage to current, and it is send 1.25 volts with high current. Means processor is works with high ampere. Means each processor have some lakhs of MOSFETs or lakhs of transistors. That all that lakhs of transistors consuming more current. That purpose here we are converting voltage to current. In that situation also only this processor is working. For example, if we are giving 1.25 or 2.5 volts individually to this processor, that time processor is not working. Why? Already here we are, if we are purchasing any processor, that time that vendor is giving one booklet, user manual. In that user manual, they are mentioned this processor works with 1.25 volts.
that time you give 1.25 volts to this processor individually, that time this processor is not working. Reason is this processor is works with 1.25 volts, but a high current. High current is required. So that much of current required, that much of current producing adapter in adapter is not possible. That is the reason then we are using VRM section. This is the power supply. Means each section receiving power supply from VRM, voltage regulating module. Here, each section is here. I/O slots, gate slots, processor, and RAM slots also. Graphics chip also. These all are works with the VRM. Means they are receiving regulated power supply from VRM, voltage regulating module. Now here, this is the laptop. In this laptop, power on off button, power on off button, or power on off button switch is under control of I/O switch. Now, if you press any button, power on off button, immediately it is send signal to clock IC. That clock IC is send clock signal to this all VRM sections. That time only this VRM section is activating, and it sends supply to this all sections. And here you observe in laptop or display, the display is receiving directly 19.5 volts from your main supply. Mentioned in display. If your display is LCD display, internal have inverter section. If your display have LED display, means backlight is LED, that time also it is receiving power supply. This display is receiving raw power directly from main source, either 19.5 volts or 11.5 volts. Remaining all sections is receiving supply from here. When you are press power on button, that time here one clock IC, the clock IC send clock signal to this all VRM sections. That time this VRM sections are activated and it is send power supply to these sections. That time this all sections are working. That time only we are seeing picture on display. It means you know how to laptop or desktop machine is working. Previous class we are discussing. When we are press power on button, that time first BIOS IC is first completing post operation, power on self test. After completing power on self test, post operation, next booting. Booting means that OS is generally stored in hard disk. So now that OS is loading from hard disk to RAM, this process is called booting. After completing booting, we are seeing that Windows logo picture on screen. So this is the one. For example, if you are shut down this machine, that time also this clock IC is switch off clock signal to this VRM sections. All after completing OS shutdown, this clock IC is send clock IC is stopping that clock signal to VRM section. That time all sections is on. That means this remaining all sections is not receiving power supply. That time it is go to off mode. Now, laptop. This laptop have two power sources. For example, this is a laptop. This laptop have two power sources. One is the external, what is that adapter? And another one internal is battery. Now, when that external power is coming from adapter, how much voltage?
19.5 volts. If the external power is available, the time it is checking what is the battery's charging status. If battery status is 100%, then it is stop the charging voltage. If battery is low, means below 100%, that time it is charging the battery. Means when external power is available, that time it is charging battery. Same time it is providing power supply to laptop. Now battery charging is completed or battery is charging. Suddenly this external power is failure, means the power. Immediately this laptop is switched from external power to this battery. That purpose internal have one switching IC. What is the main function of this switching IC? Is means here the switching IC function is first it is verifying external power source is available or not. If external power source is available, that time it is giving first preference to external power source. It is using that external power source and it sends that power to laptop remaining all sections. If external power source is not available, immediately it is switching to battery. For example, now laptop is working with the external power source. Suddenly this power is failed. Immediately this switching IC is switching from external power to battery and it is receiving power supply from battery. Here external power source how much? 19.5. Battery how much? 11.5 volts. So immediately switching from 19.5 to 11.5 volts and it sends that power supply to left. This is the output. And this is the one input and this is the another input. First, this switching circuit is means this circuit is giving first preference to external means adapter supply. If this supply is not available, that time it is receiving supply from battery and it is send that supply to this output means laptop sections. All sections works with 11.5 volts means all sections have VRM section. That VRM section is receiving 11.5 volts. If suddenly external power is available, immediately it is detecting and it is switching from 11.5 to 19 volts. And same time, this IC is sent charging voltage to battery. That time, this battery is charging. Same time, this power supply is using laptop remaining sections. For example, this IC is failure. That time, your laptop is totally dead condition. Means your laptop is not receiving power supply from battery and your laptop is not receiving power supply from adapter. Sometimes this laptop is works with battery but this laptop is not works with adapter. That time also problem with this switching IC. Means here this switching IC is receiving two inputs. For example, this section is not working. That time your laptop is not receiving supply from adapter. Your laptop is receiving supply from battery. So these are the common problems in motherboard per se. General common problems we are discussing after completing this one. So here laptop have two power sources. One is the adapter and another one is the battery. Laptop always is giving first priority to this adapter, external power source. If the external power source is available, that time always it is depending on external power source. If external power source is not available, that time it is depending on internal power source. Internal means battery. If external power source is available, that time it is charging this battery and same time storing this power supply to laptop remaining section. And here another condition is here. Generally, if we are using battery, actually battery is full charging means 100%. Some persons, if the battery charging is reduced from 100 to 80%, it may be they are charging battery. It is not yet good. If you want battery more life, if you want this battery more life, that time you wait up to 10%. If your battery is up to, means your battery charging status is 100 to 10%, when your battery status is 10%, charging is 10%, that time
you charge your battery. When some persons always, when 10% is reducing, when 20% is reducing, you may say they are charging battery. It is not good. When battery charging charging is reducing 100 to 10% or 100 to 15%, that time only you charge your battery up to 100%. Don't charge 50% or 30%. When your battery charging is come down 10%, that time you charge your battery 10% to 100%. Now you are using your laptop with your battery, that time you have now present your battery status is 80%. Don't connect immediately adapter. You wait up to 100 to 10%. When your laptop battery charging status is 10%, that time only you connect adapter and you charge it fully. That time only your battery is doing more lag. Means don't charge frequency to your battery. When your battery state level is come down up to 10% or 15%, that time only you charge your battery 100%. That time only your battery is giving more life. Otherwise, your battery efficiency is reducing. Means previously your battery is giving 4 hours backup. Frequently, if you are charging your battery, that time it is giving 3 hours or 200 hours. So frequently don't charge your battery. When your that battery status is come down 100 to 10%, that time only you connect adapter and you charge it. Now, in laptop, general problems. In desktop or laptop, general problems is first one is no display. No display. Generally, no display problem is coming. Second, first in this. RAM sticks. Means generally sometimes these RAM sticks with contact points with carbon. So that time you remove that RAM stick and you clean that contact points by using pencil eraser. Again you insert. So that time also problem is not solving. That time you connect another working RAM stick into your laptop and check once again. That time also display is not coming. That time you are suspecting your laptop display. Maybe problem in display section. So now you how to rectify problem in display section or problem in graphics memory controlling hardware. Means a problem in notebooks or problem in display, problem in RAM slot or RAMs. That time also no display problem is coming. Now first we are checking RAM. Means we are removing RAM and we are cleaning the RAM contact points by using pencil eraser and we are inserting and we are checking. Problem is not rectified. So that time you remove the RAM and you insert another working RAM and check. That time also no display problem. Means problem is not rectified. So that time you connect external monitor. Means every laptop have external port, either VGA port or HDMI port. You connect the monitor to your laptop and you switch. Means use function button and the monitor symbol button. That time it is giving that video output outside. Means outside. So that time you check. If our external monitor is working. Means external monitor is showing your Windows display, but your laptop display is not showing. Means the same problem in your display. Next, after you are checking RAM stick, means RAM section is okay. Next, check
display by using external monitor. For example, here we are using external display. That time external display is working, but our laptop display is not working. So that time we are suspecting laptop display. Means sometimes your motherboard, laptop motherboard to display connecting cables are damaging. Means frequently they are folding that display. That time that cables are damaging. Sometimes display backlight also damaging. Means CCFL. Means that CCFL is works with DRM section. That DRM section also sometimes damaged. Sometimes CCFL lamps is damaged. But present days we are using LEDs. So sometimes display to motherboard cable is damaging. Sometimes display is damaging. These two reasons. So external monitor is working, but internal display is not working. That time you check to display backlight and display cable. Both are good condition, means you replace display. Sometimes external monitor also not working. Means your laptop display is not working. Same time external monitor also not working. If problem in graphics memory card will have, if problem in graphics memory card will have, that time we are not getting display. That time problem is not the build or generally we are called GMCH. And next problem. No comment. Sometimes if you press any button, power button, that time laptop is not on. Means totally dead condition. If you are connecting battery charging, means adapter, that time also it is not showing battery charging status. So that time no power. First we are in no power condition, that time we are connecting laptop adapter and switch on power supply, and we are observing battery charging power LED is glowing or sometimes blinking. We are observing that one. If that power LED is glowing, means input supply is coming properly. Means that adapter connecting socket and adapter is okay. Next, we are checking no power. If no power is problem is coming, generally problem in power on off switch. Sometimes that switch is damaging. So first you check that switch continuity. If switch is okay, that time we check that power on off switch. It is receiving 3.2 volts from north bridge. So first we check that supply is coming or not. If supply is coming, then we are pressing button, the time laptop is not on. The time problem is sound bridge. Reason is this sound bridge send signal to clock IC. That time this clock IC only send clock signal to VRM section. That time only all VRM sections working. And this all sections providing power supply to all this processor north bridge, south bridge. Means if south bridge this power on section is not working, that time this laptop is dead condition. But it is showing battery charging status. This is another problem. Next, keyboard not working. If keyboard not working, first we remove the keyboard connector. Means in this they are using flexible printed cable, flexible printed circuit cable. So first we are clean this FPC connector or cable by using pencil eraser, and we are inserting once again. That time if it is working, okay. If it is not working, that time we are suspecting keyboard. Means keyboard is defective. Keyboard is defective. Means first we are checking that keyboard connecting strip. Generally we are called strip. That strip you clean by using pencil eraser. After you connect once again and check. That time keyboard is not working. Means internal keyboard is not working, external keyboard is working. So that time problem is keyboard. Replace this one. Sometimes touchpad also same problem. Touchpad is not working. So that time you remove the touchpad connector and clean that by using pencil eraser and insert once again. That time also touchpad is not working. That time you replace that touchpad. Generally, every OS, nowadays every OS have inbuilt keyboard and touchpad. Basic input drivers is available with every OS. In olden days, this drivers is not available. But present days, this drivers is available with OS. When we are installing OS, automatically this keyboard and touchpad and drivers is installed. Only we are installing audio drivers, video drivers, LAN drivers, Wi-Fi drivers we are installing externally. But nowadays, Windows 8, Windows 7, Windows 10 also have inbuilt motherboard drivers. Means that OS is coming with the motherboard drivers. So that when we are installing OS, automatically this all drivers is installed and your laptop is working properly. But in older days, after completing installation, we are installing this Wi-Fi drivers, LAN drivers, and display drivers, and audio drivers individually, one by one. But nowadays, this drivers is available with OS. That is present day's main advantage. The next problem is LAN not detecting or Wi-Fi not detecting. Generally, if Wi-Fi is not detecting or LAN is not detecting, then first we are suspecting that drivers, Wi-Fi drivers or LAN. If the drivers is not matching or if the drivers is not installing, then this laptop is not detecting Wi-Fi networks. So Wi-Fi not. Now Wi-Fi not working. Wi-Fi not working means the name of the object Wi-Fi driver. First check Wi-Fi drivers. Next, we'll check Wi-Fi card. These two are the main problems. Sometimes no audio. If in laptop speakers is not working, then you connect your headphone and you check. Headphone means headphone is working properly, but laptop speakers is not working. That time you are first you are subscribing laptop speakers. Laptop speakers. And next, sometimes you check the speaker connectors. Generally, if you have opened this laptop for general servicing purpose, means if you are using laptop 1 year or 1.5 year, that time dust is formed internally. Means laptop internally have an exhaust fan for cooling purpose, process cooling purpose. That time this fan is receiving cool air and it is cooling that condenser and that hot air is coming outside. So that time this fan also absorbing some dust. So when we are opening this laptop for general servicing purpose, that time we are connecting, we connect all connectors properly. If you are missing a touchpad connector, if you are missing the speaker connectors, that time we are not, that time this touchpad or speakers is not working properly. So when we are doing general service, that time when we are assembling, after completing the cleaning, when we are fixing that laptop, that time compulsory we check each cable and connector is connecting properly or not. And here, if here in this no audio means here headphone is working properly but speakers is not working, but sometimes headphone also not working. So in that situations, in that situation we are checking that audio drivers. Means headphone and speakers. Speakers, these two are not working. But here, headphone is working. And speaker not working. Speaker not working. So in this situation, we are checking laptop speakers and the speaker connector. But here headphone and speakers not working. Let them first you check audio drivers. If you are not installing audio drivers or you are installing other version of audio drivers, then this type of problem is coming. But nowadays every OS have inbuilt all drivers, audio drivers and video drivers, Wi-Fi drivers, latest OS. Next problem is battery not charging. Actually, if battery is not charging, Second, we are suspecting battery charging circuit. Or sometimes the battery is weak, means it dead condition, that is totally is dry. That is dead, that time also battery is not charging. So before we are checking this battery charging circuit, first we are confirmed that battery is good condition or not. How we know? The time you connect another good condition battery to your laptop and once again check. The time that battery is charging properly. But your battery is not charging. So that time you are suspecting problem in battery. Sometimes your battery is not charging, other battery also not charging in your laptop. That time you suspect battery something is wrong. This is a chip level defect. It is not required for our process. So you check this battery charging. If you have different camera, you check the components. If any component is damaging, you replace them. And here, some laptops starting when we have switch on power supply, that time that laptops is first initially they are taking supply from means a laptop on purpose they are depending on battery. If your battery is dead condition, that time you are connecting adapter and you try to switch on your laptop. That time your laptop is not switched on. Reason is your laptop is good condition, but first, they are taking supply, means switch on, when you are press power on button, that time it is switch on purpose, they are taking supply from your battery. But some laptops, if any source, either battery or adapter, if input source is available, that time it is utilizing that source and it try to switch on laptop. But some laptops, they are only depending on battery. If your battery is dead condition, that time if you are connecting adapter and you try to switch on that laptop, that time laptop is not switched on. That time you don't confuse. First, you try to charge your laptop battery, if possible. If not possible, you connect another battery and you try to switch on your laptop, that time laptop is switched on. Means if battery is also, if battery deep discharge, that time some laptop is not power on. Reason is this laptop initially switched on purpose they are taking supply from battery. If you keep your laptop long term, not using long term 6 months or 8 months, that time your laptop battery is internally discharging. That time you try to switch on your laptop, that time laptop not switched on. Why? Reason is your laptop is depending on your battery. If battery is a deep discharge, that time it is not switched on. So that time you try to first you try to charge your battery full. After you try to switch on, if your battery is dead condition, that time you replace battery, new battery. That time your laptop is working properly. So no display problem and keyboard problem, touchpad problem, audio speakers problem and battery problem. Today we are discussing. Next class we are observing laptop motherboard on motherboard sections, each section. Means we are observing processor section, north bit and south bit, I/O ports. We are observing everything in next class. In tomorrow class we are observing all sections on laptop motherboard. And today, now question time. If you have any doubt, you type on message box.
Sir?
VRM stands for voltage regulating module. VRM means voltage regulating module.
सर आपकी पिक्चर स्टिल हो रही है.
वन मिनट मैडम. व्हाट इज बेटर लाइफ ऑफ पीसी? जनरली लैपटॉप बैटरीज वर्क्स अप टू 3 to 4 years. इफ यू आर मेंटेनिंग, इफ यू आर चार्जिंग बैटरी इन प्रॉपरली, if you are charging properly, that time
sir aapki picture still ho rahi hai aur awaaz bhi break ho rahi hai.
And now I am changing my network and now I am trying to switch to my wifi connection.
Okay, because aapka picture bhi ekdam still ho raha hai.
And once you check them, oh, okay.
Yeah, now it's fine.
EMCH means graphics memory controlling hub. Generally, we are called, it is called as a North Bridge. Generally, we are called North Bridge, but technical name is GMCH, graphics memory controlling hub. It is organizing RAM slots, graphics chip, and it is also organizing VGA port, GMCH. This is a technical name, graphics memory controlling hub. Next, any doubt?
So just before this, there was a question which you were answering. Can you repeat that? Just before this.
VMCH?
No, not VMCH. Regarding the laptop. So just before this, the regarding the laptop screen and if it's not working.
I'm repeating that once again.
Sir, I'll speak with you later. That's fine.
Okay, madam. Okay, madam. Thank you, madam. Sir, what is CNR? What is CNR? CNR, we are not discussing CNR.
Hello, sir. Hello.
Tell me.
Hi, sir. This is Dhirendra. Actually, I wanted to know what is battery life. If I have not used my laptop since last 5 years, then how much should be confident that this battery is almost damaged? Completely damaged.
Not using your laptop more than 1 year, that time your battery, your laptop battery life is reducing. If you are not using more than 3 years, means your total battery is dead condition. Means your battery is not working.
So, is it possible to check battery voltage using multimeter, sir?
It's possible. It is showing 11 volts. You keep your multimeter terminals, this last side and that last side, that I'm showing 11 volts, 11 or 11.5 volts.
Oh, okay, sir. Actually, I had consulted with one expert out there, another expert like you. They told me that if you are checking without inserting, you know, in your laptop, battery voltage is 3.7.
No. Internally connecting series connection and yeah. They are giving output 11.5 volts.
Okay, sir.
Volts. If you check that battery, if your battery is good condition, that time it is showing 11.5 volts.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much, sir.
Okay.
And sir, one more question, sir.
Tell me.
When we have to check our power switch button, when on the motherboard there are two points just beneath of the power switch, just beneath of the power switch there are two point on the motherboard.
Yes. So
if we are shorting it using the tweezer, we can check it that it is a safe way to check that computer, my laptop is getting on or not. Did you get my question, sir? Hello?
Cut the end. Hello? Tell me.
Sir, I'm asking that if I am using my tweezer to short the power button, it is a safe way to check that my PC is getting on or that. It is safe way, sir. We can check.
For example, if you are suspecting your power button is not working.
Yes, sir.
That time you short two terminals by using tweezer, better you use insulated tweezer.
Okay, sir.
Means if you are not maintaining ESD wrist strap, that time sometimes your chipset is damaging.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Okay.
Over, sir.
Okay. Explain again charging process of battery. Means here, this battery internal have nickel cadmium, this lithium ion cells. When external power supply is available, means when you are connecting your laptop adapter, that time this switching section, it is send that 19 volts to charging section. That charging section is send 3.3 volts to each cell. Means that cell charging purpose, it is receiving 3.3 volts and that cells are charging individually. But that cells all are connecting in series connection. The charging time, they are receiving power supply individually. 3.3 volts. So that 3.3 volts is providing charging section to each cell. In previous class, we are discussing this lithium ion cells. Here, depending on our battery status, they are connecting two cells parallel or one cell. Means depending on that your laptop here, two cells. The two cells here, it is showing 3.7 full charging voltage. But your laptop is providing 3.3 volts for charging purpose. This adapter internal also have one charging circuit. That charging circuit is providing each cell purpose individual supply. And these cells are charging individually. When you want power from battery, that time these all cells are seriously connected and it is providing 11.5 volts to your laptop. Means here simply when outsource, means adapter supply is available, that time this battery is charging. When adapter supply is not available, immediately laptop is receiving supply from battery. That purpose here they are using one switching IC. Means that switching IC main function is, first it is giving first preference to adapter supply. If adapter supply is available, that time it is send this adapter supply to laptop, same time it is send this adapter supply to charge, means battery section. If battery is fully charged, that time the charging section is not receiving that supply and it is keep quiet. When battery is below 100%, that time only the charging section is sent 3.3 volts to this adapter, laptop battery section. Means when your battery is below 100%, that time the charging section is sent charging voltage to battery. If battery is full 100%, that time charging section is keep quiet, it is not send charging voltage to battery. And suddenly if outside adapter supply is not available, immediately this switching circuit is connecting battery supply to your laptop. If adapter supply is available, immediately it is connecting adapter supply to your laptop. Means internal have one switching IC. This IC is always monitoring this adapter supply and same time battery supply. If adapter supply is available, it is connecting adapter supply and it send to laptop. If adapter supply is not available, it is connecting to battery supply and it send that battery supply to your laptop. Switching instruction. Generally, Wi-Fi is not working. Means that time first you check Wi-Fi drivers properly installed or not. That is the first one. If Wi-Fi drivers is installed, that time your laptop is here showing available Wi-Fi networks. If it is not showing that Wi-Fi networks, means problem in Wi-Fi drivers or problem in your Wi-Fi card. Means sometimes we are installing Wi-Fi drivers, but that driver's version is not matching to your laptop. Means when you are installing drivers, that time it is showing drivers installed properly. Message is coming. That time what we are thinking, means this drivers is supporting to this laptop, but that drivers is not supporting to your Wi-Fi. That is the reason. First, you verify which drivers, which version is compatible to your laptop model. Sometimes, if you are installing other version of Wi-Fi drivers, that time it is giving one error message. This drivers is not compatible to your laptop. But sometimes, when you are installing other version of drivers, the drivers is installed properly, but the drivers is not supporting to your Wi-Fi card. So that time this type of problem is coming.
कोई भी वीडियो
में आवाज आ रही है चैट में. एनी क्वेश्चन? नाउ टाइम ऑल्सो ओवर, वी डिस्कस इन नेक्स्ट क्लास. टुडे वी कंप्लीट अवर सेशन. If means power supply is available, you work with adapter, no problem. For example, if you are working in your home, power supply is available, that time you work with adapter, no problem. When you are going outside, that time power supply is not available, that time you depend on laptop battery. If you are working in home, that time you depend on adapter, no problem. Means the laptop is compatible with adapter and battery. In your home, when you are working in your home, that time you connect your adapter and you do your work. When you are going outside, that time you depend on your laptop battery. That time no problem. But some students is depending, means some students is thinking this adapter only charging for battery purpose, but it is not correct. You work your, means you use your laptop by using adapter. When power supply is not available, that time you depending on your battery. That time your battery is giving more life. Means don't depend always on your battery. If you always depend on your battery, that time your battery is in short time your battery is dry. Means your battery life is reducing. If external power, means external power is available, that time you use your laptop adapter. External power is not available, that time only you depend on your laptop battery. But don't use always your laptop battery. I think today time is over. We will discuss in next class. By using one laptop motherboard. Today we close our class.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Thank you, madam.